各位在线上的牧者同工和弟兄姐妹们，大家早上好。
Dear pastors, co-workers, brothers and sisters, good morning.
今天我们晨祷是来看箴言书十四章。
Today we are looking at Proverbs chapter 14.
箴言呢，其实是一些忠言劝诫的话。
Proverbs are some of the warnings and also teachings.
它充满着智慧，还有真实的忠告。
And filled with a lot of wisdom and also true teachings.
当我们如果真的是喜欢这个箴言的话
，If we truly love the Proverbs,
它真的是可以帮助我们的生命，还有我们生活每一个的层面哦，能够做一个有知识的人。
It can help us to become men of knowledge in every aspect of our lives.
有智慧，而且呢，它也教导我们如何做对的选择。
To have wisdom and also to make the right decision.
该走什么样的路
？And also to take the path that we need to take.
从箴言第十章一直到第十二十一章
，From Proverbs 10 until 21,
都是论善恶的箴言。
It is talking about discerning between the good and bad.
教导我们如何分辨善恶。
Teaching us how to discern between them.
而今天呢，我们来看第十四章的时候
，As we are looking at Proverbs chapter 14,
你会看到很多遗忘啦、愚昧啊、愚蒙和智慧的字眼。
You discover that there's a lot of words such as foolish, foolishness, the simple, and also wisdom.
所以我给这一章的主题就是远离遗忘。寻求智慧，敬畏耶和华。
And therefore, I give a title that is "Stay away from foolishness, seek wisdom, and fear the Lord."
我今天呢，在这一章里面，我要分享四个点。
I would like to share 4 points from these proverbs.
第一个点呢，就是遗忘人拆毁，智慧人建造。
And the first point is fools destroy, but the wise man build.
第二个点呢，就是遗忘人任性，智慧人警醒。
The second point is the fools are willful, but the wise men are cautious.
第三个点呢是愚妄人易怒，智慧人安静。
The third point is the fools are easily provoked, but the wise men are quiet.
第四点就是敬畏耶和华是生命的泉源。
The fourth point is the fear of the Lord is the fountain of life.
所以第一点，愚妄人拆毁，智慧人建造。
So for the first point, fools destroy, but wise men build.
我们来看。第一到第三节
So let's look at verse 1 until verse 3.
智慧妇人建立家室，愚妄妇人亲手拆毁。行动正直的敬畏耶和华，行事怪僻的却藐视他。愚妄人口中骄傲，如杖折打己身。智慧人的嘴必保守自己。
The wise woman builds her house, but the foolish pulls it down with her hands. He who walks in his uprightness fears the Lord, but he who is perverse in his ways despises him. In the mouth of a fool is a rod of pride, but the lips of the wise shall preserve them.
愚妄是什么意思呢
So what does it mean for the foolish one?
就是愚笨、愚蠢。
It means that those who are stupid and also foolish.
还有呢，他很粗俗、很粗暴、粗野的人。
And also those who are vulgar, rough, and also boorish.
智慧的妇人呢，靠什么来建立她的家呢
？How does this wise woman build her house?
而愚妄的妇人又用什么东西来拆毁她的家呢
？And by what does this foolish woman tear down her house?
当我们继续的往下看的时候，我们就会看到。就是用言语。
As we continue to read, we will discover that it is through the words.
智慧的妇人呢，会用她的话语来帮助丈夫。
The wise woman will use her words to help her husband.
使丈夫成功。
So that her husband can be successful.
用智慧的言语来教导儿女乖巧敬畏神。
And using wise words to help the children to be obedient and also fearing the Lord.
使她的家庭呢，能够蒙福和兴盛。
So that the family can become blessed and also prosper.
但是愚妄的妇人呢，她没有帮助她的丈夫和儿女。
However, the foolish woman didn't help her husband and also her children.
反而呢，用苦毒的话啦，或者是咒诅的话来咒骂丈夫儿女。
Instead, she used her words of curses to curse her husband and also her children.
那她就是亲手拆毁了她自己的。丈夫和儿女的生命
，and therefore she personally tear down the life of her husband and also her children.
他们心灵受伤，造成很多的纷争啊，或者是暴怒。
Their hearts are hurt, and also there's a lot of strife, and also there's a lot of division.
他的家庭就会因着他的口， 而亲手被拆毁了。
She would tear down her family by her own words.
为什么这里会说到妇人呢？
And why does it mention the woman here?
圣经并不是说把所有建立家室的责任放在妇人的身上。
It doesn't mean that to place the responsibility of building the household upon the women only.
只是箴言呢很常将智慧还有愚昧呢拟人化。
But often the prophets we personify the wisdom and also the foolishness.
所以以女性来代表。
And that we use the woman to represent this.
因此这里就提到妇人。
Therefore here it used the word the woman.
所以呢其实无论是妇人或者是丈夫他们在建立家室里面同样要负起很大的责任的。
Therefore, whether it is the woman or the man, they take the responsibility in building the household.
所以一个智慧的妇人和一个愚妄的妇人呢，所建立的家室是很大分别。
There's a great difference between the household that the wise woman and also the foolish woman built.
因为一个人的行为哦，无论是他做出来的啦，或者是他讲出来的话，可以反映他对神的态度。
Because whether it is the word spoken by a person or the behavior that is being exerted by a person, it will show their attitude towards God.
正直人哦，会按着他的言行举止哦，来取悦神。
The righteous man will actually try to please the Lord by their actions.
他做什么，他都会先想到神，因为他是敬畏神的人。
In what they do, they will be thinking about pleasing the Lord because they are the person who fear the Lord.
可是行事这个怪癖的呢，他就是偏行己路，自己想要怎么样就怎么样，他不理神会想什么。
But those who are perverse, they will be willful and do what they want and will not care about what God thinks.
所以他心中无神，目中无人。
They will not regard God or man.
因此，愚妄人的口哦，他的口中都是充满着骄傲、狂傲的话。
Therefore, in the mouth of a fool is the rod of pride.
最后呢，这些狂傲的话呢，将会变成处罚自己的杖。
And all these arrogant words shall become the rod that punish them.
因为愚妄人呢，他说这些狂傲的话，他不是要建造人，他乃是要羞辱人、践踏人的。
Because as these foolish people, they speak all these arrogant words is not to build people, but to step down and also trample upon people.
最后呢，这一些话语哦的结局，反而会临到自己的身上。
And the outcome of all these words will come upon the speaker itself.
而智慧人的口呢，他说出来的话，他就是要安慰、建造、造就和劝勉别人的。
And while the lips of the wise is to edify and also to comfort other people.
所以他说出来的话，他是要保守这个人，所以他同时也保护了自己。
So what they are saying is preserving others and also preserving themselves.
我看到有一些人的家庭哦，真的是在家中有愚妄的妇人或者是愚妄的丈夫。
And I see that in some families, there are really some foolish wife and also foolish husband.
说话非常的粗俗。
And they are speaking vulgar words,
带给家人很大的痛苦
bringing a lot of suffering to the families.
当孩子还小的时候，他们没有能力反抗。
When the children are young, they don't have any strength to resist that.
他们只能默默地去承受一切苛刻、苦读、咒诅的话。
They can only bear the words of hostility and also curses.
但是当他长大了
as they grow up,
他有能力了
they have the ability,
他们就会反抗
they will resist,
而且他会加倍地还给父母
and they will even repay in double portion.
或者是他会远走高飞，离开这个家不再回来
or they will leave the family as far as possible and never return.
他们心里的这个受伤啊，需要很长的时间来去医治。
The hurts in their lives require a long time before they can get healed.
他们需要很多神的恩典，很多的爱才能够走出来。
They need the grace of the Lord and also the love of the Lord to walk out of the hurts.
但是若是一个智慧人智慧妇人所建立的这个家庭呢
But for the family that was being built out by a wise woman
家里是充满着温馨喜乐的
The family is filled with love and also warmth.
丈夫儿女都很想要回家
The husband and also the children love to come back home.
而且当自己年老的时候
And when she's old,
你的孩子会很乐意的来照顾你
Your children will be willing to take care of you.
所以求神来帮助我们所有无论是男人或女人
May God come and help us, all of us, whether it's men or women.
保守我们的口
To preserve our words.
要成为建造人、祝福人的智慧人
To become the wise man that build out others.
第二个点呢，就是愚妄人任性、 智慧人谨慎。
Is the fools are willful, but the wise men are cautious.
我们来看十二到十六节。
So let's look at verse 12 until 16.
有一条路人以为正，至终成为死亡之路。人在喜笑中，心也忧愁。快乐至极，就生愁苦。心中被盗的，必满得自己的结果；善人必从自己的行为得以资助。愚蒙人四话都信，通达人步步谨慎。智慧人惧怕，就离远离恶事；愚妄人却狂傲自恃。
There's a way that seems good, right to a man, and but its end is the way of death. Even in laughter, the heart may sorrow, and the end of mirth may be grief. The backslider in heart may be filled with his own ways, but a good man will be satisfied from above. The simple believes every word, but the prudent considers well his steps. A wise man fears and departs from evil, but a fool rages and is self-confident.
他说有一条路是一条康庄大道。
It says that there's a way that seems right to a man.
很多人走这一条路。
A lot of people travel in this path.
很容易走，很方便，很自由。
It seems very easy and also very convenient.
只需要极少的牺牲。
You only need to sacrifice very little.
靠一些行善啊，或者是好行为就可以蒙福，可以得救。
Just do some good deeds and you can be saved.
人以为这是正路。
And man thought that that's a right way.
但是走到最后的时候才知道是一条死亡之路。
But as they travel to the end, they discovered that that was the way of death.
人往往用自己的聪明，用自己的眼光来衡量事情。
And men like to judge according to their knowledge and also their understanding.
或是我们看到，哎，很多人在做这样子的事啊，同样的事啊，所以不用想了，肯定是对的。
Or we see that a lot of people are doing such a thing. We don't have to think, just follow likewise.
走这一条路的人呢，他们外表是笑的，其实在心里面是痛苦的。
And those who travel in this way, they are laughing outwardly, but inside they are having sorrows.
外面看起来，哇，欢喜快乐，可是走到最后的时候却是痛苦。
Outwardly they seem to be joyful and also laughing, but inside there's actually grieving.
耶稣也说过类似的话。
Jesus also says similar words.
在马太福音七章十三十四节，耶稣说：“你们要进窄门，因为引到灭亡，这门是宽的，路是大的，进去的人也多；引到永生，那门是窄的，路是小的，找着的人也少。”
In Matthew chapter 7, verse 13 and 14, it says, Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate, and also broad is the way that leads to destruction, but there are many who go in by there. Because narrow is the gate, and difficult is the way which leads to life, and there are few who find it.
第十四节他说，心中被盗的，就是说远离耶和华的人。
And in verse 14, in the Proverbs, it says that the backslider in heart, that's those who go against the Lord,
他们必承受他们任性的后果。
They shall be filled with their own ways, the consequences.
因为他走这些小路，可能哇就不够痛快，不够畅快，感觉是慢，很慢。
Because they feel that this narrow way is not as carefree and also not as fast.
所以最后呢，选择康庄大道，哇，很快。
So they choose to travel by this broad way that is very fast.
因此他要自己承担那个后果。
They need to bear the consequences themselves.
而正直的人呢，虽然他走小路，但是呢，却是，就是这条路呢，他可以得到满足。为什么呢？因为那是耶和华的路。
A person who travels by the narrow way, although it is a narrow way, they will be satisfied from above because that is the way of the Lord.
十五节这里说愚蒙人是什么意思呢？
In verse 15, it mentioned the simple. What does that mean?
愚蒙人就是很单纯、很天真的人。
It is those who are ignorant and also very naive.
这里说愚妄人是话都信。
And here it says the simple believes every word.
意思是说他很容易被骗的，他没有辨别的能力。
It means that he can be deceived easily and he doesn't have the discernment.
很容易被人影响。
Can be influenced by people easily.
为什么有些不是从神来的话或者是一些谎言哦，这么容易就来勾引我们离开或者是去相信呢？
And why is it that some of the words that are not from God and also some lies can actually entice us to depart from the Lord?
这个是跟我们的心思意念有关的。
And that has to do with our thoughts.
因为我们每天所想所听的不是神的话。
Because every day what we are listening is not the word of God.
我们爱听人的话。
We like to listen to the words of man.
我们爱听谗言。
We like to listen to gossips.
我们心里所想的都是世俗的东西，自己的欲望。
And what we are thinking about are the secular things and also our own desires.
赚钱啊，名利啊，等等。
And to earn money and also our status.
所以别人讲了一些话呢，就很容易把我们吸引去了。
So when other people say certain things, it's so easy to entice us.
通达人就是他非常的精明，非常的明智。
But those who are prudent, it means that those who are shrewd and also those who are wise.
所以他是谨慎，而且他有分辨能力。
He will consider well his steps and also he has discernment.
16节说，智慧人惧怕。
In verse 16, it says that a wise man fears.
这惧怕是因为他敬畏神。
This fear is because he fears the Lord.
他小心，非常小心谨慎，要远离恶事。
He's very careful in departing from evil.
不要掉进网罗。
And not to fall into the traps.
可是愚妄人呢，却过分的自信心啊。
However, a fool rages and is self-confident.
总是觉得哎呀，没事的啦。
And feel that nothing will go wrong.
所以这一段除了是在信仰的路上我们需要谨慎以外，
Besides in the journey of faith that we need to be careful.
其实在我们的日常生活中每一个的领域我们都是要谨慎的。
In every aspect in our daily lives we also need to be cautious.
近期在马来西亚非常猖狂的是骗局。
And lately something that has been rampant in Malaysia is the scheme cases.
有一些是在网上的骗局了。
Some are the scam that's going on online.
特别是非常孤单的女生啊，要在网上结交朋友。
Especially lonely girls is trying to find friends online.
遇到了骗子。
They encounter those who are deceivers.
或是有些人呢，打电话来说，哦，有人盗用你的东西啊，然后你现在你是犯法啊，做很多犯法的事情。
Or some people will call and say that some people are using your bank account and you are doing something illegal.
所以你要坐牢啊。
You shall be in jail.
但是呢，你可以拿一些钱，可以去打官司。
But you can take out some money and file a lawsuit.
然后做一些手续，你就有安全了。
Go through this procedure and you'll be fine.
或者是有一些人就告诉你，有一些的投资，它有很快很高的金额回报。
And some people are telling you that you're making this, you can make this investment with high returns.
这些骗子所讲的话，哇，真的很像真的。
And what this scammer says seems to be so real.
但是我们要步步谨慎。
But we need to be cautious in every step.
要有分辨的能力。
We need to have discernment.
我们不要成为遗忘人，是话我们都信的。
And let's not become the simple and believe every word.
免得我们掉入了网罗。
Lest we fall into this trap.
因此我们不要孤立我们自己。
Therefore, let us not isolate ourselves.
反而需要常常谦卑自己，我们可以去询问牧师啦、组长啦，或者有关的专业人士。
We need to always humble ourselves and inquire of the pastors, our cell leaders, and also the professionals.
这样我们就得到保护了。
So that we can be protected.
第三个点是愚妄人易怒，智慧人安静。
The third point is the fools are easily provoked, but the wise men are quiet.
我们来看第十七节。
Let's look at verse 17.
轻易发怒的行事愚妄，设立诡计的被人恨恶。
A quick-tempered man acts foolishly, and a man of wicked intention is hated.
还有第二十九节，不轻易发怒的大有聪明，性情暴躁的大显愚妄。
He who is slow to wrath has great understanding, but he who is impulsive exerts folly.
箴言呢，常常提醒我们要有 EQ.
And the Proverbs always remind us to have EQ.
要做好我们的情绪管理。
To manage our emotions well.
轻易发怒呢，在这个箴言里面常常被形容为行事愚妄的。
Those who get angry easily is always described as those who are foolish.
因为人一发怒，脑袋呢就停不下来，不能去想想那个后果。
Because when we are angry, then we cannot stop and also think about the consequences.
完全失去理智。
We lost our rationality.
可能呢就会砰一声关门。
Maybe we'll just boom and also bang on the door.
丢东西，然后破坏家具。
To throw things and also destroy the furniture.
大声咒诅或者是辱骂。家人
curse loudly and also to shout loudly at our family members.
然后呢，就气哄哄的驾车离开了。
And so angrily, we just drove away.
哎，可能在离开过后呢，哇，他就要开快车发泄心中的那个愤怒。
And after driving off, we just drive so fast to vent our anger.
最后可能就中了罚单啦。
Maybe some will receive a fine.
或者严重的啊，可能会遇到意外呢
？Or most severely meet with an accident.
有一些人呢是用赌博啊来发泄他心里面的那个愤怒的。
And some people use gambling to vent their anger.
然后呢，欠了一大笔债
，and owe a great amount of debts.
害了自己，连累了家人。
And to cause damage to himself and also the family members.
行出来的都是愚妄的事情。
And what is acted out are all acts of foolishness.
人为什么会这么容易发怒呢？
And why is it so angry, easy for men to be angry?
可能是内心里面哦，有惧怕。
Maybe because of the fear inside of us.
有比较，没有安全感。
There's comparison and also lack of a sense of security.
自卑啦，或者是嫉妒啦，等等。
Inferiority and also jealousy.
所以他用发怒来掩饰或者是掌控。
And he's using anger to disguise all this and also to control people.
其实说到这里，我自己想到我刚进中学的时候呢，我也是一个很容易发怒的人。
And I thought about when I just entered into the secondary school, I was also a person who get angry easily.
因为呢，我比较有比较的心，还有嫉妒对我的一个很好的朋友。
Because I have the heart of comparison towards my good friend.
她是我的邻居。
She is actually my neighbor.
有一天我发现她跟我哥哥交往，拍拖。
And one day I discovered that she's in a courtship with my brother.
没有告诉我，是我发现的。
Without telling me, but I actually found that out.
哇，我非常的生气。
I was so angry.
我感觉到她抢走了爱我的哥哥。
I thought that she actually snatched away the brother that really loved me.
因此我跟这个朋友翻脸。
And therefore, I did not want to befriend her anymore.
我也跟我哥哥翻脸。
And likewise, I didn't want to befriend my brother.
对很多人，很多的事情，开始呢就很容易的发怒。
I started to get angry easily at many things.
然后导致呢，我其实失去很多很亲密的朋友。
And caused me to lose a lot of intimate friends.
过去很亲密，但是现在因为常常发脾气，就比较疏远了。
In the past, we were very intimate, but because I got angry so easily, and therefore we were not as close as before.
自己也觉得不自由。
I also felt that I was not as free.
明明是很开心的。
Initially, I was so happy.
可是一看到他们呢，我就怒气就来了。
But when I saw them, I was so angry.
没有办法去控制自己的情绪。
I couldn't control my emotions.
其实这个维持很多年。
And this has gone on for many years.
后来呢，我觉得是圣灵来帮助我有一个醒觉。
Later, I discovered it was the Holy Spirit that helped me to have this awakening.
就是要学习去接纳人。
To learn to accept others.
好好管理自己的情绪。
And to manage my own emotions well.
当然后来我们也都和好了。
And later we are all reconciled.
然后接下来我们看第三十节。
As we look at verse 30.
他说心中安静是肉体的生命，嫉妒是骨中的朽烂。
A sound heart is life to the body, but envy is rottenness to the bones.
心中安静的意思呢是心理健康情绪平稳。
A sound heart means that the heart is healthy and likewise for the emotions.
心里为什么会健康呢？
How can the heart be healthy?
因为他生命的安全感建立在天父的身上。
Because the sense of security is built upon the Heavenly Father.
所以我们不需要去跟别人比较。
We don't have to compare ourselves with others.
我们不会因为别人比我们强，我们就会嫉妒，我们就会怀恨。
We'll not be jealous and also harbor hatred because others are better than us.
反而我们还可以去祝福他们。
We can even bless the other person.
心理健康的人哦，清楚知道神看自己是独特的。
And those who have sound hearts know that God has viewed themselves as unique.
有一个满足的心在里面。
There's satisfaction inside of them.
因此呢，一个人若是他这个健全的心灵哦，他的身体也是健康的。
For a sound and also healthy heart, they also have healthy body.
有生命力的。
Have life inside of them.
因为身和心是一体的。
Because the heart will actually affect the body.
相反的，如果他的心不安静，就是心不健康。
On the other hand, if the heart is not quiet and also is not healthy,
心里充满着这一些的嫉妒的人会怎样呢？
It is filled with jealousy. What will happen to such a person?
嫉妒是他骨中的朽烂呢。
Envy is the rottenness to the bones.
为什么呢？
Why is that so?
因为嫉妒哦，会产生各种不各样的这一些负面的思想情绪。
Because envy or jealousy will give rise to a lot of negative thoughts and also emotions.
如怨恨啊，不平啊，不甘心啊，等等。
Such as hatred and also feel that this is unfair.
这样其实会影响我们的心思意念，非常的烦躁和混乱。
And this will cause our thoughts to be very chaotic.
刚才说身心是一体的。
And just now we say that our soul and also our body is together.
心理不健康，然后自然身体也不健康。
So when the heart is not healthy, likewise they will go to the body as well.
所以我们要求神帮助我们成为一个情绪管理的好管家。
We need to ask the Lord to help us to become good stewards of our emotions.
也医治我们的心灵。
And also heal our soul, our heart.
使我们的心中能够安静。
So that in our heart we can be quiet.
心里面是健全的人。
Our hearts are sound and healthy.
这样的人呢，才是可以真正的自由。
Such a person can truly be at liberty.
最后一个点。
And the last point,
敬畏耶和华是生命的泉源。
The fear of the Lord is the fountain of life.
我们来看26到27节。
So let's look at verse 26 to 27.
敬畏耶和华的大有依靠，他的儿女也是避难所。敬畏耶和华就是生命的泉源，可以使人离开死亡的网罗。
In the fear of the Lord, there is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life to turn one away from the snares of death.
要成为智慧人呢，首先要敬拜耶和华。
To become the wise man, we need to first worship the Lord.
因为敬畏耶和华是智慧的开端。
Because fearing the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
就是智慧的开始。
Is the beginning of wisdom.
因此，敬畏耶和华的智慧人啊，
Therefore, wise men who are fearing the Lord,
我们是有耶和华的大能成为我们的盾牌的。
We have the power of the Lord as our shield.
所以无论遇到什么样的苦难，
regardless of what kind of suffering we are facing,
耶和华是我们非常坚强的一个后盾。
The Lord is our strong fortress.
是我们可以安心可以去靠的。
It's the one that we can rely upon.
不单只是我们自己。
Not only for ourselves,
耶和华也会是我们儿女的避难所。
The Lord will also be a place of refuge for our children.
我们儿女也可以在这个的避难所里面躲避风雨和危险。
Our children can also take refuge in this place in their time of storms.
敬畏耶和华也是我们属灵能力，还有以及是我们的生命力的这个源头。
Fearing the Lord is also the source of life and also power.
是生命的源头。
It is the fountain of life.
它能够使我们呢，本来是走向死亡的，但是因着耶和华，我们可以回头。
Initially, we're walking towards the snares of death, but because of the Lord, we can turn ourselves away from that.
我们可以离开死亡的网络。
We can go away from the snares of death.
所以弟兄姐妹，
Therefore, brothers and sisters,
今天我们透过这一章。
Today through this chapter,
我们要求神来帮助我们，无论是在我们的口舌，
We ask for the Lord to help us whether in our words,
或者是我们做任何的选择，
or in all the decisions we make,
或是我们的情绪管理，
or in our emotion management,
都要成为一个蒙福的智慧人。
We want to become a blessed wise person.
生命能彰显神的荣耀。
In our lives, we can manifest the glory of the Lord.
愿神祝福凡听他话语的人。
May the Lord bless those who listen to his words.
好，接下来呢，我要把这个时间交给同工来带领我们进入追求祷告的时间。
I shall pass the time to a co-worker to lead us into the time of prayers. Dear brothers and sisters,
今天呢 ，Pastor Hosanna 跟我们分享愚昧跟智慧。
Today, Pastor Hosanna is sharing with us between the foolish and also the wise.
我相信呢，透过今天的信息呢，神在呼召我们要选择成为一个有智慧的人。
And I believe that God is calling upon us to become the wise man.
我们这个时候呢，可以为着我们自己的生命来反省。
We can reflect upon our lives right now.
在我们生命里面，我们愚昧的成分有多少？有智慧的成分又有多少呢？
In our lives, what is the extent of us being wise, and also what is the extent of us being foolish?
我们是一个容易发怒的人吗？
Are we a person that get angry easily?
还是我们是一个平静安稳的人呢？
Or we can be quiet and also manage our emotions?
我们任性吗？
Are we willful?
还是我们是一个谨慎的人？
Or are we cautious?
那在我们生命中有没有很多 拆毁的事情发生呢？
In our lives, do we have a lot of destruction happening?
还是我们的生命就是建造很多很多美事的一个生命？
Or our lives build out a lot of beautiful things.
我们这个时候求圣灵来帮助我们。
We ask the Holy Spirit to help us right now.
求神启示我们里面到底还有多少的愚昧。
To inspire us and to know how much foolishness there is in our lives.
如果有的话，我们求神来帮助我们。
If there is, we ask for the Lord to help us.
透过敬畏耶和华
，through fearing the Lord,
我们便能够成为有智慧的人。
We can become those who are wise.
因为敬畏耶和华就是生命的泉源。
Because fearing of the Lord is the fountain of life.
但是愚昧呢，却将我们引至死亡里面。
But foolishness would guide us into the snares of death.
那我们一起来为自己祷告。
Let's come and pray for ourselves.
求神来帮助我们。
And ask for the Lord to help us.
检视我们里面的愚昧。
To examine the foolishness inside of us.
求神将愚昧拿走。
And to take away the foolishness.
也求神帮助我们越来越敬畏他。
And to ask the Lord to help us to fear him more and more.
那我们来回应神。
Let's come and respond to God.
主啊，你是一个有智慧的神。
Lord, you are a wise God.
你是我们的生命泉源。
You are the fountain of life.
你更是创造我们的神。
You are our creator.
主啊，我们有你的形象。
We have your image.
主啊，我们就有你的智慧。
And therefore we have your wisdom.
主啊，在我们的生命里面，很多时候我们可能选择了愚昧。
In our lives, often we choose foolishness.
我们选择了不敬畏你。
We choose not to fear you.
导致我们生命中有很多不在神你心意里面的事情发生。
That causes not to walk in your will.
主，今天我们来到你的面前。
Lord, today we come before you.
主啊，求你来帮助我们。
And ask for you to help us.
帮助我们越来越敬畏你。
Help us to fear you more and more.
帮助我们将你放在我们生命中的首位。
And to place you as priority in our lives.
在我们的日常生活里面，神啊，我们以你的心意为准。
In our daily lives, we follow your will first.
主，让我们里面更多更多活出神你喜悦的个性来。
That will live our character that's pleasing to you.
主啊，帮助我们。
Lord, help us.
让我们可以成为一个有智慧的人。
That we can become wise men.
我们能够建造很多美好的事。
We can build out a lot of wonderful things.
在我们的情绪管理方面，神啊，我们谨慎，我们安静平稳。
In our emotion management, we are quiet and also cautious.
主啊，以至于我们真的可以从神你里面领取生命。
That we can truly receive life from you.
我们更能够成为造就别人的人。
We can become people who build others.
主啊，我们渴慕这个的智慧。
We desire to have this wisdom, Lord.
我们渴慕这个的敬畏。
We desire to feel you more, Lord.
主啊，帮助我们。
Lord, you help us.
让我们里面能够生发这个全心全意的敬畏。
That we can give up this total fearing of the Lord.
在我们的生命里面，在我们的生活领域里面，我们选择敬畏你。
In our lives and lifestyle, we choose to fear you, Lord.
主啊，相信我们的生命一定会不再一样。
I believe that our lives will no longer be the same.
主啊，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
赐给我们智慧。
Give us wisdom.
让我们在凡事上荣耀神你的名字。
That in all things we can glorify your name.
主，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
垂听我们的祷告。
Listen to our prayers.
奉耶稣的名求。
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
是的，弟兄姐妹。
Yes, brothers and sisters.
当我们越靠近神
，The more we draw closer to God，
我们就越有智慧
；The more we have wisdom，
愚妄就会越来越少
；The foolishness will become lesser and lesser。
让我们一起来领受神的祝福。
Let's come and receive the blessing of the Lord。
天父，我们要谢谢你
，Heavenly Father， we give thanks to you。
主啊，你透过今天箴言书十四章
，The true Proverbs 14，
你告诉我们
，You're telling us
要远离遗忘。
to depart from foolishness.
我们要寻求智慧。
We want to seek wisdom.
因为智慧在你里面。
Because wisdom is inside of you.
所以我们最重要的就是要敬畏你。
Therefore, most importantly, we want to fear you.
所以我奉耶稣基督的名字祝福所有在线上听晨祷的弟兄姐妹。
In Jesus' mighty name, I want to bless all the branches who are listening to morning devotion online.
我们都有一个能听的耳。
That we have ears that can listen to you.
而且呢，我们能够真的花时间来到神的面前，安静等候你。
We spend time to come before you and to listen to you.
让神你的工作在我们的生命里面不断的炼净。
Allow God to continue to refine our lives.
谢谢你，耶稣。
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
祝福凡听神你话语的弟兄姐妹。
Bless all the brothers and sisters who listen to your words.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
好，今天我们的晨祷就到这里。
That's the end of morning devotion today.